Do you remember feeling warm and fuzzy the last time you held hands with your partner? If yes, it was the love hormone giving your heart the warmth you felt. The love hormone, or oxytocin as you science nerds know it, is produced in the hypothalamus part of the brain. It's a neurotransmitter involved in childbirth, breastfeeding, and sperm movement. The levels of oxytocin increase during hugging and even orgasms. Today, we'll be talking about the love hormone, taking you through its production in the body, hormonal interactions, and its effect on emotions and behavior. Number 1. What is the connection between love hormone and love? Oxytocin's release is associated with trust, empathy, sexual activity, and relationship building. Its amount is usually higher in females than in men. Studies have shown that couples in their initial stages of dating have higher levels of oxytocin in comparison to the times when they're single. This can explain those butterflies you felt when you hugged your partner for the first time. It is interesting to know about such bodily changes associated with love, right? To know more about them, watch the video "What Happens to Your Body When You Fall in Love," linked down below. But it's not just love this hormone is capable of regulating. Oxytocin levels shoot up during sexual activity and intense orgasms. It can drive trust, empathy, and reminiscence of beautiful times. Hey, don't blame the poor hormone for opening your diary and reading your old love letters. That's its job. If it stops doing so, you'll be having never-ending trust issues. Number 2. Can your body produce it? No matter how skilled you are at hiding from love, it'll find you when it has to. Why? Well, because oxytocin is produced naturally in your body. It's produced by the hypothalamus, but secreted in the pituitary gland. It's synthesized and transported to the posterior pituitary, from where it's secreted directly into the bloodstream. It is also secreted within the brain. A small amount of it is also secreted in ovaries and testes. It's normally packed in small granules, which are secreted along carrier proteins called neurofysin. What is its connection with dopamine and serotonin? Pharrell was probably high on the hormone Trinity when he wrote his iconic hit, Happy. By Trinity, we mean oxytocin, dopamine, and serotonin, collectively known as happy hormones. There's a cascade that follows when you see your crush. Not just freezing externally and acting all dumb. The brain releases high amounts of dopamine, which in turn pumps your serotonin levels. As a result, there's a surge of oxytocin. All of this is supposed to make you feel good. Do you see? Your body does such an elaborate hormone play, hoping you'll gather enough courage to talk. Come on, champ, you can do it! Can oxytocin affect social behavior and emotions positively? The answer is yes. It can help the body adapt to complicated and stressful situations, both emotionally and socially. During arguments, intranasal oxytocin is proven to help with better communication. In fact, in a 2010 study, it showed signs of helping autistic patients understand and respond to social cues better. Oxytocin is also responsible for making you feel comfortable and relaxed in a social setting. It drives trust and overall psychological stability. It's the hormones that help you loosen up, not the shots you took last night. All right, well, the tequila may have helped a little. Number 3, the relationship between parenthood and love hormone. Oxytocin plays a multidimensional role in motherhood. Starting with being a helping hand during labor, it gives the first signal for uterine contractions. Smooth muscles of the uterus start pushing the baby faster and also signals the release for other related hormones. Post-delivery, oxytocin restores everything how it was. No, it can't get your pre-pregnancy physique back, you'll have to sweat that one out, but it surely can help in restoring your uterus. Oxytocin helps in the next step too. Babies latching on their mother's breast triggers a hormone release. Oxytocin's high levels, in turn, stimulate milk release by mammary ducts. But its work isn't done yet. Mother's bond with her child is also driven by this hormone's level. Studies have shown that mothers with higher levels are more likely to have a stronger bond with their baby. These mothers would engage in more affectionate behaviors such as checking in on the baby, singing lullabies, and grooming. A stronger motherly connection makes the levels of oxytocin in a child higher as well. This results in a child seeking more contact and hence strengthening the bond they share. The magic of oxytocin is not only limited to biological mothers. The case is very similar even with foster mothers. Plus, don't you assume it's affecting only motherhood. Fathers observe a similar boost of oxytocin with their infant's contact. In a 2010 study, activities such as directing the baby's attention towards an object and making the baby explore were performed. These interactions between father and baby showed increased oxytocin levels on both sides. And now you know why all the dads love playing peekaboo with their little ones. Number 4. Oxytocin and fidelity. Is there a connection? To be truthful, there is a vicious cycle. Oxytocin has a unique ability to make individuals see their partners more attractive than other familiar or unfamiliar ones. This is actually due to a behavior loop. Oxytocin acts very wickedly. It functions on a reward pathway. Having sexual contact with your partner or engaging with them socially increases oxytocin levels. The more you get, the more you seek. So the more oxytocin you produce, the more you desire your partner. There are literal studies that show the hormone being able to influence males into keeping a social distance from other females. Don't be too quick to generalize men, though. A 2014 study proved something similar for females. Female subjects treated with oxytocin showed reduced infidelity. They preferred interacting with their own partner more than strangers of the opposite sex. Number 5. Why is the effect different in males and females? Please, don't answer that back by saying, duh, because bodies are different. I mean, you won't be entirely wrong even if you say that. But like, give me the opportunity to explain it scientifically. The portion of your brain responsible for regulating emotions, motivation, and reward are known as the amygdala. This hormone acts differently depending on if it's a man or a woman. In females, it can help them solve the confusion about whom to make their bestie and whom not to. Cheers to the channel name reference. On the other hand, for males, the hormone plays a role in identifying competitive roles. In a threatening situation, it helps them decide whether to fight or run away. Whoa, though, don't call your man a coward for his hormonal actions. Number 6. What are the medical uses and side effects? With the roles well understood, it's easier to understand its medical applications too. During childbirth, oxytocin can be used to induce contractions and reduce bleeding. Oxytocin, due to its ability to act directly on the brain, is being explored for wider applications. It's currently being researched upon as a possible treatment for postpartum depression. With certain side effects, such as synthetic form showing an increased risk of anxiety disorders, the study is still underway. It's been found to be helpful in the cases of autism, developmental disorders, and some psychiatric conditions involving impaired social interactions. Last but not least, alcohol and substance abuse disorders also have their hopes for possible treatment in this area. Studies are still on. Let's hope for the best. But don't get swayed with all the goodness. Let us warn you about the side effects too. Oxytocin has been linked with feelings of envy, dishonesty, and favoritism. Even though the effects and side effects might sound contradictory, one must remember the biosynthesis and cascade interactions of hormones are complicated. There are always risks involved in things not going the way they're expected to. Should one be held accountable for their bad behavior, or are your hormones the real culprit? Sound off in the comment section below. And don't forget to hit the bell and subscribe for more amazing content from your bestie. Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait, what kind of bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.